Hi, are you looking to get into web development and more specifically into e-commerce web development? Well, certainly this year is great for that. We've already seen a 40% growth this year in e-commerce sales overall. It stopped all of last year's sales and it's exceeded all of last year's sales before the holiday season has even started. And last year was a record year, but this year is topping all records in terms of e-commerce. What does it mean for you if you want to get into the industry, if you want to offer technical solutions like e-commerce websites or e-commerce web applications in the industry? This is a great year to start. This is a growing industry, and I highly recommend that you get into this. So in this video, we're going to cover which platforms you should learn that are currently growing, because most e-commerce websites are not built from scratch. They're built using platforms like Shopify and others, and how to learn how to use those platforms and how to optimize your business so you actually build a sustainable business by learning the platforms and offering the development services to customers who are looking to buy stuff like that. So we're gonna cover all that in this video. Before we get started, why should you listen to me? Well, I've been in the industry since 2008, and I've helped over 750 people also get into the industry since 2014. So here's a link to my website where you can see all the interviews I did with my clients. Before we start, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification icon so you get future e-commerce development updates from my channel. So let's talk about which platforms are the most used platforms right now based on builtwith.com. So WooCommerce Checkout, which is basically WooCommerce, is the number one platform worldwide, followed by Shopify, followed by Magento. Magento is kind of an old school one if you haven't heard about that one yet. Very old, but it's still in use. And that's for worldwide. In the United States, it starts to get a little bit more interesting because there's a little bit more of a distribution. So there's still WooCommerce on top, Shopify second, but third is actually Wix. Now, because Wix started offering an e-commerce solution, not just blogs and like photography websites. Also, there's things like Squarespace and ECWID. I don't know how to pronounce that last one because I haven't heard of that one before. But basically, if you're looking to get started, which ones of these actually require development work? Because Wix, for example, generally does not require development work. Well, actually, most of them. So WooCommerce definitely needs a web developer. You need to be a web developer to properly set up WooCommerce. It's a little bit tricky to set it up for most people. Shopify, for sure, you need a web developer if you want to do it properly. And Squarespace, oftentimes, like somewhere in the middle between Wix and WooCommerce, it's like easier, but you still should use a web developer if you want to do it properly and if you want like custom solutions, not just the out of the box thing, right? So the most common that we currently recommend is Shopify, because Shopify is actually scalable also for larger businesses. They have an amazing marketplace for apps, plugins, and so on. It's also one of the biggest companies out of all of these. The other ones are kind of smaller, but Shopify, I think it's a $100 billion company this year. They're starting to compete with companies like Amazon by building distribution channels, so they're kind of awesome. However, it is viable to offer all of these. So WooCommerce, Shopify, and Squarespace. It is viable to offer all of these at the same time if you're running an e-commerce web development agency. However, I do recommend focusing on a single one. Now, for things like Shopify, what you can do is you can go to their website and they have a whole knowledge base on how the platform works. They have also documentation for developers, so you should check it out in the description. For the other ones, for WooCommerce and for Squarespace, I'm also going to link their documentation in the description. So take a look at that right away. So how do you actually get started as a web developer? Like, okay, cool, you can learn this. It's not very difficult. If you're a good developer already, it's going to take you a couple of weeks, maybe 3 weeks, to get good enough to offer a service to a client. Now, how do you get those clients? Well, I have a whole playlist ready for you that explains the full process and how to get clients, so check it out in the description. However, let me give you a quick breakdown. So the easiest way to get started with e-commerce web development is to get on freelancing platforms, right? So what you do is you go to Upwork and you go to Fiverr and you start offering a service. You can start offering a service at $1,000 and above. Make sure that it's designed in a way where you get people on sales calls, and then you only work with clients who you're comfortable working with, okay? So this is explained in my other videos in the playlist. There's a whole tutorial just for web developers, so definitely check that out. Now, what I'm not saying is, oh, it's easy and you're just gonna get instant results. All you have to do is just join a platform and it just works. It's not quite that easy, but this is a long journey that takes at least a few months. If you're willing to start on it and put in daily effort, it is completely viable, and I've seen hundreds and thousands of people succeed at this. So it is viable if you build it up as a proper funnel for your business. And initially, you can even freelance if you're already a good developer. Now, some developers are going to say, but Alex, shouldn't you build things custom? Why use these slow platforms? Well, the thing is, if you want to offer a solution, it's best to follow where the market is going, especially if you're new, especially if you don't want to build like a whole thing and you know, try to market it, which is very expensive and very complicated. It's good not to be naive about this and follow where the demand is. These companies are creating crazy massive demand. It's already pre-built, like lots of it is already pre-built. And as such, clients want to use that. They don't want to build from scratch. They don't have the know-how, the money or anything to build things from scratch. And to be fair, with beginners in business, especially, you don't want to work with them if they want to build things from scratch. It's going to be a nightmare project that takes months or years. It's better to use an existing platform and perhaps sometimes even, brace yourself, templates. Okay, developers sometimes hate templates, but templates are amazing and are an amazing way to get things started faster. And you can still charge thousands of dollars for template implementation and customization, right? And if you start offering things like custom Shopify web development and design, then you can charge $5,000 and more, which can eventually lead to Shopify app development, which can lead to $100,000 and above projects potentially. There's a lot of space here to grow with a real business as well. It's not just for little developers who want to build like little shops for $200. It's certainly not the case. You can certainly charge good money for this. So do check out the playlist below that goes into detail on all these topics that I've summarized in this video. And I'll see you in the next video that's in the description.